fix the problem of the black window, we use a telescope X-bar Aurora 25 kilowatts. This problem can be caused from different chemicals, from different factors. One of the factors is the quality of the pellet. And if it's a good quality of the pellet, it cannot be, we cannot find a solution to be fixed at all. The other factor that can cause a problem is the chimney draft, and if there is not enough chimney draft, so we need to raise the ventilators. I'll show now which parameters you can change, but this one should actually, you have to observe the working of the pellet stove, and see maybe a few times to change little by little the parameters till you get the result that you're looking for. So let's see. We need to go to the last menu on the right side, which is the service menu. We have to go with the button plus 2, 8 and press enter. This is the code, which is always random, and the code is the sum of all these numbers. In the end, always it should be at 1. So 8 plus 0 plus 8 plus 4, it's 20 plus 1, it's 21. Let's press enter, make it 21, and press enter. It shows on, we entered the service menu, after that plus, and here are the parameters. Press enter, and this is the first parameter, 0. You have to notice in which phase of work the windows get black. If it's in the lighting phase or if it's done in normal, usually it's it can be mixed actually, but all the times it's in the lighting phase. So let's see which parameters we can check. A lot of times the reason is a big quantity of pellets in the lighting phase. So these three parameter number 3 and 4, these are the heat up sequence feeder off time, heat up sequence feeder on time. Here it's these are the basic factory settings, which is 150 150. It's okay like this. I don't think here that you need to change something. Mostly you can check number 5, 6, 7 and 8. Number 5, this is the phase of the fuel ignition. So if you notice a big quantity of pellets in the lighting, you need to raise this time off for the feeder. For example, you can make it 195. And parameter number 6, it's time on for the feeder. You can lower it 25, for example. The other phase is the ignition test, which is 7 and 8, and the logic is the same. We rise time of 150, for example, and parameter 8, we lower it by 1 or 2, little bit. Like this, we lower the quantity of the pellets. You have to do this little by little, because actually you have to check how these movements of the parameters reflects the problem. The next one, it's again the same logic, but when it's the normal phase of work. The normal phase of work for the feeder, it's parameter number 10. This is from phase 1, 2, 3 and 4 in normal work. So if we have to lower the pellets here, we lower it by a little. And parameter number 18, it's the auto mode. Again, it can be lower, the quantity of the pellet. We lower it and we need to raise the ventilator. 24. This is in a normal work. We hire it, for example, with 10, and automatically hire 1, 2, 3, and 4. If we want to hire the auto mode, we hire here, for example, with 10. And now we raise the power of the ventilator. In the lighting phase, the ventilators can be raised from here. It's from 20 to 23 included. So 20, 21, 22, 23. So if we want, we can raise and these parameters little. I think you catch the logic. It's lower the quantity of the pellets and increasing the power of the ventilator. This is one of the solutions, but of course you have to see which factor caused the problem. Is it the quantity, the quality of the pellet? If it's you know, the wrong settings, or it's the chimney draft, or maybe it's for the pellet stoves, it's time for cleaning, it can be a different thing. If you need more information, you can find it in our YouTube channel, Energy Economy. Thank you.